Welcome. Science 6th standard, third chapter, fibre to fabric, part 1. Paheli and Bhujo won the first prize in the science quiz competition held at their school. They were very excited and decided to use the prize money to buy clothes for their parents. When they saw a large variety of the cloth material, they got confused. Say, so many metals, you visit a cloth material, then you'll come to know variety of the clothes available in the cloth shop. The shopkeeper explained that some clothes or the fabrics were cotton and some were synthetic. He also had woolen mufflers and shawls. There were many silk saris as well. Paheli and Bhujo felt very excited. They touched and felt these different fabrics. Finally, they brought a woolen muffler and a cotton sari. After their visit to cloth shop, Paheli and Bhujo began to notice various fabric in their surroundings. They found that bed sheets, blankets, curtains, tablecloths, towels, and dusters were made from different kinds of fibers. Even their school bags and gunny bags were made from some kind of the fabric. They tried to identify these fabric as cotton, wool, silk, or synthetic. Can you also identify some fabrics? Go home and search for the clothes available at your home, and then you'll come to know variety of the clothes. Touch them and feel how they are. 3.1 Variety in fabrics. Activity 1. Visit a nearby tailoring shop. Collect cuttings of the fabrics left over after stitching. Okay, there you'll get small pieces. Feel the touch each piece of the fabric. Now try to label some of the fabrics as cotton, silk, wool, or synthetic. After asking for help from the tailor, enlarge the view of a piece of fabric. Do you wonder what these different fabrics are made of? When you look at any fabric, it seems a continuous piece. Now look at it closely. What do you notice? Activity 2. Select a piece of a cotton fabric you labeled in activity 1. Now try to find a loose thread or yarn at one of the edges. Okay. When your mother buys a new sari, it has threads before giving pico. Okay. Pico we call, or zigzag we call. Before doing that, you observe the sari. If you can remove the threads from that and pull it out. If no loose yarns are available, you can gently pull one out with a pin or a needle. We find that fabric is made up of yarns arranged together. What are these yarns made of? Fabric activity 3. Take out a yarn from a piece of a cotton fabric. Place this piece of yarn on table. Now press one end of the yarn with your thumb. Scratch the other end of yarn along its length with your nail as shown in the figure 3.1. See how you take out the thread from the material. Do you find that at this end, the yarn splits up into thin strands? Okay. Splitting the yarn into thin strands, the yarn split up into thin strands like this. You take out the thread out of it. You might have observed something similar when you try a needle. Many a times, the end of the thread is separated into few thin strands again. This makes it difficult to pass through the thread through the eye of the needle, the small hole below that needle in your home while making a mala. You can try this, that even the thread has a splits. The thin strands of the thread that we see are made up of still thinner strands called the fibers. Fabrics are made up of yarns, and yarns are further made up of the fibers. Where do these fibers come from? The fibers of some fabrics such as cotton, jute, silk, wool are obtained from the plants and animals. These are called natural fibers. Cotton and jute are examples of the fibers obtained from plants. Wool and silk fibers are obtained from animals. Wool is obtained from the fleece of sheep or a goat. It is also obtained from the hair of the rabbits, yak and camels. Silk fiber is drawn from the cocoon of the silkworm. For thousands of the years, natural fibers were the only ones available for making fabrics. In the last 100 years or so, fibers are also made from the chemical substances, which are not obtained from the plant or animal source. These are called synthetic fibers. Some examples of the synthetic fibers are polyester, nylon, or acrylic. Bhujo has seen in the museums items like one shown here, like this. These were worn by warriors. He wants to know if these are made of some kind of fiber. No, these are made up of the metals. Some plant fibers, cotton. Have you ever made wicks for eye lamps, oil lamps? I don't think so. Now you'll see the oil lamps at your homes because you have generators and lights are there. What do we use for making these wicks? This cotton wool is also used for filling mattresses, quilts, or the pillows. Take some cotton wool, pull it apart and look at its edge. What do you observe? The small thin strands that you see are made up of the cotton fibers. Where does this cotton wool come from? It grows in the fields. Cotton plants are usually grown at the places having a black soil and warm climate. Can you name some states of our country where cotton is grown? The fruits of the cotton plant are about the size of a lemon. After maturing, the balls burst open and seeds covered with the cotton fibers can see. Have you ever? The plants are like this. They must open in the field only. Then only they cut off the crops. Field of the cotton plants. See a cotton field that is ready for picking. It looks like a field covered with snow. From these balls, cotton is usually picked up by hands. Fibers are then separated from the seeds by combing, and this process is called ginning of the cotton. Ginning was traditionally done by hand. These days, machines are also used for ginning. Ginning means just rolling that cotton like this, taking thread out of it with the hand. You can use simple machines or the complex machines for that nowadays. Jute. Jute bags. Have you seen jute bags? In nowadays, plastic bags are coming for the rice, what we quintal rice, half quintal, or 25 kg or 10 kg rice, white, or rice or a wheat, what we buy. But before that, 1 quintal jute bags were available when we were kids. Nowadays, plastic overtook everywhere. Jute fiber is obtained from the stem of the jute plant. It is cultivated during the rainy season in India. Jute is mainly grown in the West Bengal, Bihar, and Assam. The jute plant is normally harvested when it is at flowering stage. The stems of the harvested plant are immersed in the water for a few days. The stems rot. The stems rot and fibers are separated by hand. Like this, you will get a thread from that. Making yarn from the cotton, it is. To make fabrics, all these fibers are first converted into yarns. How it is done? Spinning cotton yarn. You can try making cotton yarn yourself by hand. Like Gandhiji used charaka for making the yarn. Activity 4. Hold some cotton wool in your hand. Pinch some cotton between the thumb and the forefinger of the other hand. Now gently start pulling out the cotton while continuously twisting the fibers like this. Hold a cotton ball in your hand and take a small piece in out of with your pinch and take out the thread like this. Okay, you can try at your home if cotton is available at your home. The process of making yarn from the fiber is called spinning. In this process, fibers from a mass of cotton wool are drawn out and twisted. This brings the fibers together to form a yarn. The simple device used for spinning is a hand spindle. It is called hand spindle. Those who knit the woolen sweaters, some of your mothers might have done the knitting of the sweaters at your home for you. You can see this or some decorative items with the woolens they are making. They use this device. Another hand operated device used for spinning is charaka. Use of charaka was popularized by Mahatma Gandhi as a part of independence movement. He encouraged people to wear a clothes. This is charaka. This is a simple machine used for taking out a thread in a less time. Clothes made of the homespun yarn termed as khadi and shun imported cloth made in the mills of the Britain. To popularize and promote khadi, the government of India constituted a body called khadi and village industries. commissions in 1956. Spinning of the yarn on large scale is done with the help of the spinning machines. After spinning, yarns are used for making fabrics. Yarn to fabric. Now we learned how to take out a yarn or a thread out of the raw material like a cotton or a jute, anything. After taking out the thread, what they will do with that thread? Using that thread, they'll prepare the material, raw material for the clothes. These are many ways by which fabrics are made from the yarns. The two main processes were weaving and knitting. Okay, weaving. In activity 2, you might have noticed that the fabric is made up of two sets of yarns arranged together. One is horizontal and one is vertical. The process arranging two sets of yarns together to make fabric is called weaving. Let us try to weave some paper strips. Then you'll understand it better. When we were kids, we used to play a lot with this. It was not there in syllabus. On our own, we are playing with this kind of papers. It was not there in the syllabus, but it's good that it is now included in the syllabus also. Take two color papers and cut this into this horizontal. Fold it and cut it like this. Fold this and cut it with these lines, according to these lines, with a scissor up to this, and insert these paper strips as another color paper strips into that. You'll get a mat like structure. You get this is how the threads are yarn. They are very thin, you cannot make it out. Observe the cotton material, you can understand that. Take two strips of the paper of different colors, cut square pieces of the length and width equal to 30 centimeters from each side. Now fold both of these sheets into half. On one sheet, draw lines as shown in the figure. Now on the other hand, shown in the 3.12, cut the both the sheets along the dotted lines and then unfold the weave strips one by one. Throw the cuts in the sheets of the paper as shown. Cross the patterns after weaving all the strips like this. What they are telling, the process they are explaining here, this will be ready for you with the two color paper sheets. You can observe this kind of the material you get after that. In similar manner, two sets of the yarns are woven to make a fabric. The yarns are much thinner than our paper strips. Of course, weaving of the fabric is done on the looms. Some simple machine is used for that. The looms are either hand operated or power operated. Okay, the human beings are used to knit the clothes like this. You weaving process in textile industry steps by step explanation. This video is no need to go to industry to observe this. You type this link in your Google, you'll get this video. Watch this full video. You'll get the knowledge of how the yarn is knitted. This is horizontal and this is a vertical thread is coming one side. The horizontal is coming. See, this is the weaved material. They are getting out of it, but the operation is done by the human beings. The hand loomed materials are still costly because that quality is different only. Machine loomed materials are different. Knitting. Have you noticed how sweaters are knitted? In knitting, a single yarn is used to make piece of fabric. Have you ever pulled the yarn from the torn pair of socks? Okay, what happens? A single yarn gets pulled out continuously as a fabric gets unraveled. See, let's take your uniform. Okay, different kind of materials are there in your uniform. See, socks is made of a woolens, and your pant or a short material is different. Your shirt material is different. Your tie material is synthetic. Tie is made up of synthetic material. Okay. The school logo on your shirt or the pant that is made with a different fabric, there only you'll get. And your school bag material is different. Okay, that is synthetic material. And your shirt and pant are not completely cotton. They are mixed now. They are mixing different materials now. Now, so much improvement have been done in this field of weaving of the clothes. We are getting different variety of the clothes now. Weaving and knitting are used for making different kinds of fabric. These fabrics are used for a variety of the clothing items. See, hand knitting it is with the help of the hand, with this material, this tool is used for knitting. See here, this just you go to Google and type this HTTPS, this whole thing there, then you'll get this video. Or otherwise you type how to crochet for absolute beginners basic crochet stitches. You type this, you'll get the video, and you watch this video, you'll come to know how the knitting is done with the hands. Otherwise, if some of your mothers are knitting sweaters or any decorative items for the house, then you'll definitely have seen these materials at your home and saw how they knit the design materials. Sahil wants to know if you have seen any fabrics that are made of the fibers on the outer covering of the coconut. What are these fibers normally used for? History of the clothing material. Have you ever wondered what materials people used in the ancient times for the clothes? It appears that in those times people used a bark and a big leaves of the trees or the animal skins and furs to cover themselves. After people began to settle in the agricultural communities, they learned to weave twigs and grass into the mats and baskets. Okay, with the bamboo also people are knitting the chair. And you'll see the shops by the roadside. You go and observe how they knit that. Once the animal fleece or hair were twisted together into the long strands, these were woven into fabrics. The early Indians wore fabrics made out of the cotton that grew in the regions near the Ganga River. River Ganga, flax. Cotton rolls, after getting converted into fiber, this fiber, after spinning, converted into yarn. This yarn is knitted or weaved and becomes the fabric. Yarn is a thick strands of the fibers. It is also the plant that gives the natural fibers. In ancient Egypt, cotton as well as the flax were cultivated near the river Nile and were used for making fibers. In those days, stitching was not known. People simply wrapped the fabrics around different parts of their body. Many different ways of draping fabrics were used. See, we Indians also drape a sari. That is called draping. How you wear a sari, that is called the draping. With the invention of the sewing needles, needles were not there at the beginning. People started stitching the fabrics to make clothes. Stitched clothes have gone through many variations since this invention. But is it not amazing that even today sari, dhoti, lungi or turban is used as an unstitched piece of fabric? Just as there is a large variety in the food eaten all over our country, a large variety exists also in the fabrics and clothing items. Please subscribe my channel, hit the bell icon and save the playlist. Thank you very much. Bye bye.